Welcome to Lauterbach's first video demo. In this video, we are going to show you some basic features about debugging a practice script. A practice script is a file containing a set of practice commands all put together in order to speed up debugging through its automation. Practice scripts are useful for board bring up and preparation for debugging session, flash programming, GUI customization, and test automation. So Trace32 provides its script debugging capability to make it easier for the user, first to understand the steps of a script, second to find bugs when someone is developing a script. For this tutorial, we are using Trace32 PowerView for ARM architecture with a release version of February 2014 64 bits. So let's start. In order to debug a practice script, click on the File menu, Edit Script, select the CMM file, and when the window containing the practice script pops up, click on the Debug button here on the right side. Let's explain the use of each one of these buttons. The Step button is used to go through the code line by line. The same for step over, but this skips the execution of the sub-block like functions or subroutines. The button continue executes the script at once, it stops only if there is a breakpoint. The button stop stops the execution. The button undo is used to make an end to the script. List shows the content of the currently loaded practice script. Macros contains the practice stack frame and the practice macros. Edit is useful to modify inside this script. And finally, breakpoint to show the list of this file's breakpoints. So now we are debugging our script. Let's reset the system. Then clear the content of the area window in case it contains some garbage from the last manips. The following block selects the CPU and the system up in order to enter to the debug mode. We can put a breakpoint after this block by double-clicking on this line, and click on the breakpoint button to see all the breakpoint list. Then click on Continue to execute the part between the current PC location and the first breakpoint. When a breakpoint is hit, it is highlighted in the pbreak list. Click on Step to load the ELF file. The following block opens some windows, the list window to show the data list, the register and the area window. We can execute all this block at once, right-click and select Go Till, and all the block between the current PC location and this line is executed. So this is the source code of our application, the area window where all the logs can be seen, and here is the register window. Now we set a breakpoint at the function main of the loaded ELF file. The breaklist window contains now the breakpoint that we just set on main. Go will run the code until reaching the breakpoint at main. The script waits while the system is still in a running state. Functions like state.run will be detailed in one of the coming videos. Now we switch to high-level mode. The line print will show us where the program counter is. We can see the value by clicking on Register PC in the area window, as well as here. Same value is shown in the Register View window. Step.single steps inside the data list window, and we can type step.5 for example to step 5 times. As you can see here, this is the new value of the PC register. Finally, we reach the undo, which ends our practice program. Thank you for watching. See you in the next tutorials.